10 largely forgotten cults. The organisation that Dionne Fortune created, Alpha et Omega. She was inspired in her early life by the Theosophical Society and took on many of the mystical ideas perpetuated in the esoteric counterculture of spirituality. She had the belief in personal magic and, of course, the mythology based around Arthurian legend and the town of Glastonbury. In many ways, such individuals as Dionne created the esoteric background that inspired the later New Age movement. The Thrill Society, a society with a series of nonsensical, bizarre beliefs, the idea of the Superman and the Master Race, but their concept of this Master Race was the Thrill Race, a subterranean Superman that lived underneath the surface of the Earth. It seems to be that this is a root of some Nazi occult mysticism, but according to historians, there appears to be very little evidence that this organisation existed before the Nazis came to power, suggesting it may have been a brainchild of a high-ranking Nazi, rather than a pre-existing secret society order. Ordo Templi Orientis, a secret society created by Aleister Crowley. The famous occultist created several organisations, not least Ordo Templi Orientis. It was a kind of Freemasonic Templar organisation and associated with various organisations of this kind. As a kind of secret society, as with many secret societies of the time, shared their ideas. Although Crowley wasn't accepted by the Freemasons of the UK, he set up this organisation and cooperated and shared its ideas with affiliated organisations over in Germany and elsewhere. The motto of the organisation was, "Love is the law, love under will." And as with several organisations of this kind, it still lingers on as an alternative religion, following the teachings from Aleister Crowley in the book known as the Book of the Law. The esoteric mystic, Madame Blavatsky, originally came from Russia and had been practicing certain mystical techniques and created many of the mythologies that are taken for granted in modern New Age. She helped to bulk out a lot of the ideas with Atlantis and had a belief in anti-science and anti-evolution. The belief of the Theosophical Society was that we have not been evolving to a higher state of being, a more developed life form, but we've devolved from spiritual entities into the physical realm. The SS religion. Heinrich Himmler, head of the SS, had a strong belief in the Norse blood mythologies. He had a belief in the perfection and the brilliance of the Aryan race, and that the evidence would show that they were indeed the superior race historically. This links into Arthurian myths as well as blood mythology. Indeed, some of the places occupied by the SS during World War II were adapted, in some cases areas rebuilt, to emulate the ideas of Arthurian legend. In effect, the SS was being shaped into a new type of crusader, the warrior knights who would fight for the just cause. Amongst the various kinds of religion practiced in ancient Rome, across its long history, there are various kinds of religion, not least the cult of Jupiter, the belief in this great and powerful god that protected Rome, and the way in which leaders, and of course later emperors, would give their respect to Jupiter, building a great temple, roughly where the Vatican sits today. And it was through this worship, giving their prayers to various gods that would relate to various attributes involved in warfare, not simply gods of victory and gods of war, but gods of morale, loyalty, to comradeship. And so as a result, the Romans would have to pray to a great many gods in order to ensure that they would be victorious in battle. The restoration of the Ten Commandments was an African Christian church. It had a belief that the end was coming soon, and it would come around the millennium. In the year 2000, churches were boarded up with people inside. They were killed. Rather than it merely being a suicide cult, it was a murderous cult organized by its leader, a prophet who had lost faith from his followers. When he said the end would come, nothing happened. And due to this failure and people demanding their money back from this person who claimed to be a prophet from God, he and his key followers ended up killing hundreds of people simply because they could not deliver on their promises. The Millerites were a popular religion in the mid-19th century. They had a massive following, and they believed that the end was nigh. They believed that the world would come to an end, that the good would be saved by Jesus. And when the time came, the appointed time when the end would come, nothing happened. It was known as the Great Disappointment, and many of those people who belonged to the Millerite cause evaporated away into other religions, which were in development at the time. The Bavarian Illuminati. In Germany in the 18th century, an organization came about, a secretive society based on Enlightenment ideas, to fight against the injustice that they saw in society. The organization was seen as a threat to the various powers that be. The organization was vilified by the Catholic Church and other conservative and religious elements in Germany and beyond, seen as being the architects of various problems in the world. They were banned, and so their membership hemorrhaged into various other organizations, as well as other nations, and their progression out of the traditional views, the conservative ideas of European society. The cult of the Canaanites. Famously within ancient history, as well as biblical stories, you have the idea of the Canaanites and their offerings, human sacrifice. It is said that they worshipped many gods, that they were great polytheists, and their culture mixed into many of the surrounding beliefs. They worshipped various gods, perhaps most famously such gods as Baal. However, the key part of their cult rituals that are worth paying attention to is human sacrifice. Many of these mystical and historical ideas are largely forgotten and at the fringe of people's knowledge, despite the fact they're very interesting stories from a historical perspective.